Welcome back. We were just about to see if we could contact Consultant Iydia now.
Channels open.
Seems we can.
I'm Lieutenant Commander Data of the Starship Enterprise. I'm investigating the absence of Dr. Hoon Forsch.
As I told Constable Lixie, I don't know where she is. Must you interrupt my research with both pointless questions?
Yes, of course.
I'm afraid so. According to the constable's report, you are the preserve's consultant.
Yes, I help select and verify preserve species in the biotopes. The Morassians wanted a Federation expert, despite Lixie's objections. They were lucky to get me.
Another scientist who has a too big opinion of himself. Scientists aren't like this. Good science fiction people, science fiction writers, please understand that.
You were the last to see Dr. Hoon Forsch before her disappearance?
As far as I know, that's not a crime.
Okay, let's interrogate him.
Constable Lixie mentioned that you recommended the Ferengi trader Aramut for the second shipment.
The fact that he associates with Ferengis, that automatically makes him suspicious.
He delivers what you want on time. The constable gave me hell when she found out that he was a Ferengi. She barely tolerates me because I'm a male.
She probably barely tolerates you because you're an asshole.
I have some questions regarding several animal carcasses which we found in the doctor's laboratory.
Animal carcasses in an exobiology lab? Well, that's certainly unusual.
Sarcasm, how original.
A creature tagged as a Frednorian boar apparently died of starvation. Do you know how this could have occurred?
Sounds like incompetence to me. The watchers blindly follow whatever care instructions they're given. No personal initiative at all.
Seems like he has a lot lower opinion of the watchers than the tracker did.
The boar's identity tag is incorrect. It is actually an Akana boar. A close genetic relative of the Frednorian. However, Akana are banned for import. How did this animal get into the preserve?
It must have been smuggled in. You know, the Watchers have requested restricted species before and were denied. Dr. Hoon Forsch must have found out about it.
Okay. So Hoon Forsch accuses the constable of smuggling, and this guy is accusing the Watchers of smuggling.
Consultant, I am puzzled. Since you verify preserved species, you must have known this was an Akana. Why did you not report the misidentification?
I didn't want to. I wanted the chance to study it. It was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Who am I to deprive science of my brilliant research on such a specimen?
Okay.
Did the doctor confront any of the Watchers with her suspicions?
I think that's why she's missing. When she confronted them with the Akana, they must have stunned her. Those stunners don't trigger the surveillance system, so nobody knows about it.
You seem to have given this an awful lot of thought.
Why would the Watchers resort to smuggling?
They're fanatics out to save the endangered creatures of the universe. I've suspected them all along, especially when I discovered this mistagging. You see, these tags can only be reprogrammed by a Watcher.
Okay, let's ask him about the other carcasses.
A creature tagged as a Kujan gibbon died of a parasitic infection not found in its native habitat. How could this have occurred?
I'd say it died of neglect. Those Watchers don't know the first thing about dealing with animals. They're not scientists. They're glorified zookeepers. Why don't you go ask them about it?
A mycordae mole experienced an electrical drain from its neural pathways. How could this have occurred?
I'd say it died of neglect. Those Watchers don't know the first thing about dealing with animals.
Yeah, you don't like the Watchers, we get that.
I'd like to know what you and the doctor discussed.
When I saw her for supper the other day, she was talking about genetic samples from the last shipment. She knows I don't like to hear people talk while I eat, so she said little else.
But Dr. Hoon Forsch was cataloging Morassian species exclusively. Why would she want genetic samples from other animals in the preserve?
I don't concern myself with the lab work of junior scientists. Now, do you mind? I have important research to conduct.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you for wasting it.
Iydia's accusation that the Watchers are fanatics is certainly plausible. Collectors can be quite zealous in their pursuit of rare specimens.
Iydia certainly has a high opinion of himself. The thing he seemed most interested in was his reputation.
Thanks again there, Captain Obvious. Troy is such a big help in this game. Okay. Let's continue our quest for the power source. Oh, damn, that's where we came from. I wanted to go to the crossroads. Let's see the shuttle dock over there. If my memory is correct, that is where we'll find the power source, and it is correct.
The microgenerator uses thermal energy to replenish its internal power source.
Ooh, it's a solar-powered battery, basically.
I believe this shuttle dock also serves as the customs area. As there are no expected flights, there is no staff. This cargo shuttle is powered by two 2,250 millicochran warp engines.
Okay. Is that supposed to mean anything to me?
I do not believe that will work.
I believe it will.
I do not believe that will.
Blah, blah, blah. Okay. Power generator in hand. Let's go back to that biotope.
This is a topographical map of the biotope. The main habitats are the four tunnels within that petrified tree.
Okay.
According to the kiosk map, the series of tunnels is home to 437 plant and animal species.
What are the other ones?
According to the kiosk...
Oh. They all get the same message. And we need to use one of these field units, but we need to know which is which. I think we can use a tricorder to do that.
This Class C field unit is configured for aquatic travel. This Class B field unit is configured for mountainous terrain and tropical climate zones. This Class A field unit is configured for rocky terrain and torrid climate zones.
Okay, so I think we need to use the tropical field unit. And we will need to use it on each of the tunnels, unfortunately. And this takes very, very long. Unless you hold the shift key. Now use the bioprobe to extract the sample. There we go. Then we can send it to the second tunnel. Can I send it to the fourth tunnel without first having to extract sample? Apparently I can.
There is no sample in this field unit.
Okay. We got all samples here. Now we're gonna have to do the same thing in the other biotopes as well. Oh, but I should take the battery with me. I'll probably need it. Well, marine biotope is next. I like these backgrounds. They're nicely done. They don't really fit. It's sort of bad that this game switches between between computer-generated backgrounds and these painted backgrounds. They're both pretty, but it's sort of jarring to have the two different styles. Okay, well, I'll check out this biotope in the next video.